Al Randolph, and welcome to Morning Break. What has happened to L. Ron Hubbard, founder of one of the world's wealthiest and most controversial religious groups, Scientology? One of the issues to be discussed this morning with my first guest, Ron DeWolf, who's the son of the missing L. Ron Hubbard. Let's give him a big round of applause, please. Welcome. In 1972, you alleged in court papers that your father had lived a life characterized by severe mental illness and physical disease, consistent failure, and the use of false and fraudulent off-time criminal means to cover up these failures and to acquire wealth, fame, and power in order to destroy his perceived enemies. What made you draw those conclusions? What did you see that led you to that?
Because I lived it. 99% of what my father wrote and said about himself is totally untrue. Millions of people have taken this false data over a period of 30 some odd years and relied upon it and built a set of beliefs and built an organization. And basically those allegations that I made were true because throughout up to 1959, I was deeply involved in all of it.
What did you see specifically? I mean, give me an example. When you say criminal means, like, for example, what did you see?
Fraud and deception, involvement with, in the early days in Phoenix, Arizona, for an example, in 1952, the involvement with organized crime.
Organized crime in what capacity?
Use of Scientology money, his own money, to finance drug importations into the country from Mexico and Colombia.
You saw these things?
Yes, I was involved with several of the incidents.
You recorded any of this? You have papers to prove? Could you walk into court and prove any of these allegations?
I didn't think for years that I could. Most of it I thought was buried, but I think now, since I have been speaking out, that there has been evidence being brought forward proving those allegations.
Why did you leave the church? Because of these allegations, these things that you...
Well, I left the church for a whole wide variety of reasons. It isn't a very simple answer. I left because my wife wanted me to, and also because I wasn't making any money, because all the money flows, of course, to my father, always has. I was also tired of the fraud and the deception, plus his deep involvement in personal use of drugs on himself and others, black magic.
When you say black magic, what are you talking about? I mean, some of the things that I read in the stack of material, it sounds just absolutely unbelievable. What are you talking about when you say this?
Well, the funny thing is that the actual truth is about as far out as Scientology itself. Really, the basis of Scientology, which is rather hidden and covered over, is the occult, deep involvement with satanic powers that he felt that he was deeply involved with British black magician called Aleister Crowley, and through putting himself in deep hypnotic trances and the use of drugs on himself, he wanted to become the most powerful being in the world.
Did you consider all of this a religion?
No.
You now?
No.
Why not?
Because it's a business. It always has been. I was one of the incorporators of one of the original church organizations, and we incorporated just because the AMA and the IRS were giving him a lot of problems in the early 50s.
What was your relationship like with your father? I mean, for a lot of people, they would say, well, maybe you're doing all of this because you did not have a good relationship with your father, or maybe you're doing all this for the money. Why are you taking these stands?
Because I want to see the truth, and I can't expose my father without exposing myself. I mean, my life is pretty messed up and goofy anyway, and in actual fact, who really belongs in this chair is L. Ron Hubbard, my father. But why I'm doing it is let's lay all the facts out and let people decide.
I have a copy of a letter that supposedly came from your father, where he talks about the fact that your mother was an alcoholic and that she deserted both of you and that you are not in any position to know about him or the church. Do you believe this is an authentic letter, first of all?
I really don't know, but I know that he has these facts all filed up.
Such as?
Well, that he didn't know me very well. The fact is, from 1952 to 1959, I was very instrumental in and around the organization and the formation of it. I was director of training, taught many, better than 20 advanced clinical courses. I was chief instructor, traveled to England half a dozen times, lived with him. And so that
so
I
you're
find
saying
that
you're in a position to really know your father and the church and the workings of the church?
Oh, yes, very much so.
Why do you believe now that, or do you believe now that your father is alive?
I personally don't believe so, but
why not?
I really don't know. That's just, as I said, a personal belief, but I think that if he is alive, he is certainly quite incompetent to handle his own affairs and is being grossly manipulated by the people around him.
People such as?
Well, in my petition, we named, I believe, a 22-year-old boy with about a ninth grade education named David Miscavige, who's one of them.
And this is a person who belongs to what is called now the C organization, is that correct?
Yes, the C org. And that is the, it's sort of, could be considered the SS arm.
Now, would you explain that? I mean, who are these people? And why have you labeled them that?
Because they're very much parallel a Hitlerite-type organization.
And you realize that's very difficult for us to understand that. Here we are sitting in America today in the year 1983, and you're telling us that there's a group of young people who are like the SS.
Mm-hmm.
Why? I mean, how were they indoctrinated? Where were these young people? Where would they have gotten this concept from?
Gotten it from my father. They were raised in Scientology, and all they've known is Scientology and my father. And
were they isolated from the outside world altogether?
Not altogether, but pretty much kept in a very tight group. And, of course, outside contact and outside communication has always been kept at a minimum over the years.
When you say SS, I think about harassment, intimidation, even death threats. Have you had any of this?
Oh, it's all of it. I've been the subject of the what's called the Fair Game Doctrine, which has been in existence since the mid-50s. That simply says that anyone perceived as an enemy of L. Ron Hubbard or Scientology can be attacked, sued, lied to, deprived of property, and even destroyed without any discipline or retribution from the organization.
Someone has actually tried to kill you?
Yes, I believe so. About three or four times over the years.
But not now that you're out here public? You have not received any more threats?
No, not since I filed my petition. They've been rather quiet since then.
We're going to take a look further into that petition. We'll come right back and continue our conversation.